Hello and welcome. My name is Nate from Video Games Recon, and in this video, we're going to be talking about my top 5 most annoying things from Fallout 4. Now, before all the fanboys start sharpening their pitchforks, I just want to preference this by saying this is in no way me saying that Fallout 4 is a bad game. In fact, it's probably going to be my favourite game of the year, maybe even of the last couple of years. So think of it as me coming from a place of frustration, but still with love for the game. That said, I don't believe anything is truly perfect, and there are definitely a few things that annoy me about this game, and no one really seems to be talking about them, as all the coverage from fans of the series is almost all positive. So I figured I'd come at it from a different angle, and as unpopular as it may well be, discuss 5 things that thus far, as I'm yet to complete the game, have stopped me from thinking of Fallout 4 as a 10 out of 10 and has stranded it as a high 8, low 9 as of the day of recording. Not that I'm a huge fan of arbitrary number scores, but you get what I'm saying. Now, first off, before we get started, there will be no mention about graphics here. That sort of nonsense tends to come from people who've never played a Fallout game before, as if you had, then you'd know these games aren't about graphical fidelity. Take Fallout 3 for example. Even at the time it didn't look that great, and by today's standard, it looks like ass. Does this mean it's not a good game? No, of course not. It's still the amazing game it always was. Why? Because graphics don't make a good game. An overall good game design does, and that's what Fallout 3 has in spades, and is why Fallout 4 is also great, regardless of its so-so next-gen graphics, which in my opinion look more than good enough for purpose. So yeah, just wanted to shut that noise down before we get started. Anywho, enough of my jibber jabber, let's get into it, shall we? In at 5, we have the clunky UI / convoluted menus and confusing game saves. Okay, so this one is a bit of a job lot, but the general theme is clunky in-game menus. Now, I know Fallout has always had a bit of an unwieldy menu system, and that's part of its charm, and I'm probably going to be repeating myself a lot on this argument, but I was expecting a little more on this front in terms of evolution. Sure, it's not unusable, and if you were to depart too far from what we know, it might not feel like Fallout, but still, when you compare it to most games of 2015, it feels a little too convoluted. It's no longer 2008 and a force unto itself, and now has to stand side by side with other open world games of a similar scale and ambition. For example, Witcher 3, Arkham Knight, Metal Gear Solid, Dying Light, and so on. And in terms of UI at least, it feels it leaving a little too convoluted and old fashioned. Now, this next issue might just be a console or PS4 problem. Feel free to hit me up with your experiences if on a different platform. But all the different types of saves, be it autosaves, which if you don't turn them off happens all the time, quick saves and regular saves, these things make it quite confusing as to where your important saves are if you want to go back for any reason. As well as not being able to entirely turn off autosaves, which is very annoying, as they still happen when you purchase a perk, for example. Also, my screenshots on my saves don't seem to refresh until I reset my console, so telling what save is what is very difficult. Although, like I said, some of this could be my PS4's fault and not the game itself. 4. Settlements getting attacked when on a mission and settlement crafting in general. Okay, so if you're playing Fallout 4, then you know what I'm talking about. If not, picture this. You're in the middle of an important mission when you get a message saying one of your settlements is being attacked. Do you leave it to your NPCs to defend themselves and risk people dying and losing resources, or leave halfway through an important mission to defend your settlement? Most people will probably leave them to their own devices and carry on with the mission, as you can easily replace a settler or two. Which in itself begs the question, what is the point in having all these settlements and acquiring all these people if I'm not emotionally attached to either the people or the places in the slightest? Aside from a slight attachment to my main couple of settlements. Seriously, what's the point? It just seems like a waste of time for me, as if I store my stuff in a workbench, raiders can't steal my resources anyway. So why bother with that noise altogether? Now, before you prod me with that pitchfork again, I know you can mitigate any attacks by keeping your farming resources lower than your defense and making your settlements robust against attacks. But my point still stands, there are way too many settlements, and it sucks when they are under attack when doing something important. And a little caveat is that although crafting is bags of fun, and hours just fly by when fanning about with your buildings, trying to get them just right, the game doesn't make it easy to enjoy the building process, as the control scheme is a bit buggy. For example, I often end up removing walls and the like just because I backed out of an item tree in the crafting menu. And it's hard to make things symmetrical, as the construction often fails to snap to each other correctly, meaning you often have to do a bodge job fix just to make things look right. 3. Exploits, bugs, and wandering companions. Oh, the bugs. The bugs. And I'm not just talking rad roaches. Now, it wouldn't be a Bethesda game without a few bugs and glitches, and is nowhere near the train wreck New Vegas was at launch, which is the main reason I never played that game as much as I would have liked to. But that said, after all the hype around this game and all the time they've been working on in secret, I expected the bugs to be at an all-time minimum for a Fallout game. Sure, some are just plain funny, and I haven't come across any game-breaking bugs as of yet, although some people have. But things like the weapon, infinite money, and item glitches offer me immersion and game-breaking to a degree, as it's too easy and tempting to acquire more money than you should have, as well as weapons and armor that should be beyond your reach at that point in the game, and devalues many a mission reward. Now, of course, you could claim that using these exploits and crying about it after is your own fault due to a lack of willpower, and you'd have a point. But personally, I tried them originally just to see if they'd work, and give myself a slight edge, and although I'd kick the habit after just a few hits, but like with that of a recovering chem addict, I'd have much preferred it if the temptation wasn't there in the first place. And another little side note, often when you send a companion back to a settlement, and then go about your business or fast travel somewhere, it can take them days in game to arrive if far enough away, as they seem to walk back really slowly. Whereas although, in-game logic, you took several in-game hours to get home, you effectively teleported in real terms, whereas your companion walks back as if encumbered, and this is incredibly frustrating and worrying, as I've heard some horror stories of people losing companions altogether. So you're left biting your nails until they arrive back safe, like some sort of overprotective parent. And this leads me on to number 2 in this list. The incredibly slow rate in which any patches for exploits, bugs, or general stability issues seem to be coming through, as it's been over 10 days and still nothing. As opposed to most games these days, patching and bug squashing as they go incrementally bit by bit, should a bug be significant enough for urgent attention, whereas Bethesda seems to be taking a different tact in employing the big, slow, and all-encompassing patch ideology. Well, at least I hope that's what they're doing. Presumably we're going to get a massive patch in the coming days and or weeks to fix many of the issues discussed in this video. I don't know if we've been spoiled by games like Destiny, for example, patching on a regular basis, but it just makes Bethesda's response to things like the money exploit seem inept by comparison. It's as if Bethesda's development process is in a vacuum, and they don't realise there are many a yardstick out there in which they can be compared to now, making them appear old-fashioned and stuck in their ways on certain things. Now, before we get into the number one and my last annoying thing in this video, I just want to give a dishonourable mention to the frame rate. Personally, I haven't had it drop too dramatically, but in certain circumstances, particularly in buildings, it has been very noticeable. But for me, never unplayable, hence why it didn't get included in this list. And now finally, let's get into the main event, and my most annoying thing about this game, and that is item storage management. The hours upon hours that I've sunk into item management and storage logistics is just ridiculous. And now that everything in this game has a use, you're left hoarding near every last item. And I know you're meant to dismantle all your junk, and the components go into an independent storage area, decluttering all of your junk. But even the way in which you have to physically dismantle your stuff outside of a menu screen is clunky as fuck. and that still leaves you with all the other crap you have to manage, be it weapons, armor, aid, apparel, and God knows what else. This wouldn't be as bad if there were separate storage solutions, i.e. cabinets designed specifically for this purpose. But when you link your settlements, that's less of an option, and the only safe place where you can't have stuff stolen by NPCs, raiders, or run the risk of putting it in a file cabinet and the contents refreshing and being removed. Which, FYI, I have tried to look for confirmation online either way and still haven't found a definitive answer on. And as such, had been too chicken to risk all my stuff without a long test period. And either way, early on, that's not really an option, because of light-fingered friends, raiders if your security's not up to scratch, and low resources. And thus, you're left with the workbench, and sorting through all your stuff in one homogeneous blob of an inventory, which is so very user-unfriendly. And if you make the stupid mistake and accidentally take all your stuff out of the workbench, you have to spend the next 15 minutes putting back all the crap you don't want to carry. I know down the road you can acquire the strongback perk, meaning once maxed out you don't have to worry about being encumbered, but up until this point, you have to suffer with this mind-numbing storage solution. I have literally spent hours cumulatively sorting through my crap when I should have been on a mission or crafting a settlement. And thus, at times, it feels more like a management sim than an ARPG. And that's not what I signed up for. Sure, Fallout has always had this issue to a degree, and back in the early days of the 360 and PS3, it might have been cute. But like I said, with all those other yardsticks out there, with their own inventory solutions, it's not so charming by comparison. And on top of this, with all the settlement stuff, and now that everything has a use aside from being sold, has made the issue exponentially worse. On top of which, it's 2015, and I'm sorry to keep flogging a dead Brahmin, but does the fact that this is how it's always been make it excusable? I don't think it's game-changing or damaging just to make your menus and in-game logistics a little bit slicker. I mean, it doesn't change the fundamentals of the game to bring the UI into the 21st century, and by default, said change negate the charm of the good old Pip-Boy. So, to summarise, Fallout 4 is a great game, I've been really enjoying it, but the things discussed here suck a lot of the fun out of this game for me, whereas without these issues, this game in my mind would be a perfect 10, if such a thing is truly possible. This for me is a perfect example of a game in a state of pre-production for a long period of time, and created in isolation with its only yardstick being its own franchise. Sure, doing so keeps the DNA and fundamentals of the franchise we all know and love, but if you don't keep your eye on the competition around you and make your games more user-friendly, you're going to struggle to capture all the hearts of the newbies to the franchise in the same way Fallout 1 did for your old school fans and Fallout 3 did for peeps like me. Maybe some of the annoyance I've had with these 5 issues is partly my own fault, for boarding the hype train too early and setting my expectations too high, as I had hoped this was going to be another big jump in the series, not quite on the level of Fallout 3, but building upon the foundations of the franchise. And although we did get a few cool new additions, Fallout 4 is much the same as Fallout 3, which for the most part is a good thing. But I was hoping, seeing as we're on a new generation of hardware, and the decent amount of development time taken would mean at least the background stuff, be it menus, bugs, etc., would be slicker and buttery smooth. But again, maybe I'm just setting my expectations too high, and that's as much my own fault as anyone else's. So, that was a few things that really pissed me off of an otherwise exemplary game. And I figured, as no one in my microcosm was really talking about it, I thought I'd put it out there for some hopefully rational conversation. But with it being YouTube, probably just going to be fanboys raging out that I'm not blindly up their favourite game's ass, and have some albeit minor peeves that I can see some room for improvement on. So, if you don't want to just hate, and maybe even enjoyed this video regardless whether you did or did not agree with my thoughts, then consider liking, commenting, sharing, and subscribing for more BS of a similar nature. Thank you, and goodbye.